Trey, what trick shots you been practicing for this game?
Any trick shots this time. Hopefully I'll need them.
How is it generally different when you play an opponent the second time, especially though given kind of the classic way the first one kind of played out? Like what do you anticipate the little tweaks that might be made?
Right. I mean, usually it's different. I mean, any other opponent, I feel like it'd be different, but I feel like whenever it's them, it's the same. It's always a battle. It's one of those games. The atmosphere is crazy. Everything about it is just different. So I think there's not gonna be a lot different about the game. Obviously, I mean, some stuff will be different, whatever. But I think it'll be intense like it was last game. Crazy battle again.
Trey, coach had mentioned how yes, you guys obviously care about Saturday and the AC tournament next week, but the past few days were about getting fresh for the long run. How do you try and balance the immediacy with also not losing track of what the ultimate goal is?
I'm just trying to take it one day at a time, I think. I'm just trying to continue to improve every single day, knowing that we are preparing for the long run and for the NCAA tournament, but trying to take steps towards where we want to be at along the way.
Along that same line, how valuable were the past few days getting physically right, mentally right? How much of a relief did you get physically getting a few days off without minutes?
Right. Yeah. Getting a couple of days rest is always huge, especially at this time of year. They don't get that much, and so I'm just trying to stay fresh, mentally and physically, but stay sharp with everything as well, not get loose while we're trying to get our wet, while we're getting our rest, and be able to be ready for Saturday night.
You guys are reaching the point of the season now where the next loss could be your last, not this next game, but you're getting pretty close to that now this month. How is this team's hunger right now? You guys have always talked about you have to be hungry every game, and every game has to have the same approach. Where is that?
Right. I think it's at a high for us, for real. I think that we know what's at stake now. Obviously not tomorrow night, but I mean, at this point of the year, we're in March now, so I think we know what March is about, what this time of year is about. And we're ready every single day.
Do you prepare any differently for a rivalry game than a conference game?
Right. I wouldn't say you would necessarily prepare differently, but as far as the team goes, we know that we're all going to be playing extremely hard. The other team will be playing extremely hard. So it's just one of those games where you got to take it up a notch because of the rivalry there is a little more at stake.
You mentioned the significance of this is March now. How much of that have you had to teach to the younger guys, the freshmen, especially knowing last year everything that you guys went through?
Yeah, a little bit for sure. I think throughout the month of February, I think that's where, last year I know I started feeling the season getting longer just because you've never really been through a season like that. Goes by quick, but at the same time, it's a long season, so. I think through the month of February, that's when you start maybe not going as hard to practice or going through emotions a little bit, things like that. And so, we showed how we had loosened up a little bit there, but I think it was good for us and good for the freshmen for sure, and just getting everyone to tighten up and get back on their game.
Are there any ways you've seen Vernon's game develop over the last couple of months here as we got in the conference play?
Yeah, for sure. He's seeing double teams every time he catches the ball, if not triple teams. And the way he's working before, he's getting the ball, so he put himself in a better position to score right away instead of having to try to work through the double and triple teams and seeing so many guys in the upside and things like that. So, the way he's able to put in the work to try to make it easier on him when he catches the ball and then have the counter moves as well. When they bring those double teams.
You've obviously played against UNC here in Cameron last year. I mean, how are you preparing? What advice are you giving to the freshmen for, just what's going to be a crazy atmosphere tomorrow?
Right. At the end of the day, it's still basketball. So, the same way you prepare for any game, especially a big game, but, it's the game of basketball still. The atmosphere is going to be crazy. Everything is up a couple notches in the
describe the bonds between you and your teammates?
I think at this point of the year, our bonds are really strong. I mean, we've gone through a lot now, goods and bads, and so I think all that has made us closer and made us a really strong team here in March.
What's the difference? What differences do you see in Carolina now than the first time you guys played? Because they were obviously in the losing streak then.
Right. I mean, really, the way they played against us the first time was how they've been playing now. It's just at the end of the game, they missed some free throws, and we were fortunate for them to miss those free throws, and then we made a couple plays that got us back into it. But I mean, I think the way they played in that game is the way they're playing now. And I mean, they're really talented, and they've had that challenge all year. I think we're struggling to figure out how to play together with one another, especially when Cole went down with the injury. I think that threw things off as well. So, I mean, with the talent they have, they definitely are a good team.
Anything else?
I just have a fun question for you. Are you able to beat your brother in one-on-one?
I think I might be able to get him maybe now, but we'll have to see this summer.
Kind of thing.